Wolf, prosecutors say Jonathan Malaku's motive in these shootings was to create fear throughout this region. To prove their point, they released a dramatic video made by the shooter himself.
October 29th, 2010. As he drives, Jonathan Malaku points his camera toward the Marine Corps Museum in Northern Virginia and speaks.
That's the target, the tall building there. That's a military building.
Minutes later, he points his gun at the museum. Then he cries out. Later, his face is clearly visible. Then he makes another pass at the museum. This time, the shots are not as visible. This video, made by Malaku himself, released by prosecutors, a key piece of evidence against the former Marine reservist who's pleaded guilty to injuring government property and firearms violations. It's connected to the shootings at the Marine Corps Museum, the Pentagon, and two military recruiting stations in Northern Virginia in the fall of 2010. No one was injured in the attacks, but...
During this video, he explains his motives to create fear and terror and to close the Marine Museum.
I looked at the video with veteran criminal defense attorney Jeffrey Jacobovitz.
Was this the piece of evidence that really became a slam dunk for a guilty plea?
Well, let's assume that he's alone in the car. It would then be a slam dunk, but I think in terms of the guilty plea as a defense counsel, I would not jump into it, and I'd first ask for a psychiatric evaluation.
Prosecutors say there's no evidence anyone else was with Malaku during the shooting spree, and his defense attorney has asked for a psychiatric evaluation, but says Malaku is sane. The lawyer wants him tested for anger management issues. Before the shootings, a military official says Malaku had failed a combat fitness test. Prosecutors say this is a case of homegrown extremism. When he was arrested at Arlington Cemetery last June, officials found bullet casings, Arabic statements referencing Al-Qaeda, and ammonium nitrate used to make IEDs in his backpack. What did he plan to do at Arlington?
His stated intention was to desecrate the graves of veterans of the recent wars in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Prosecutors and Malaku's attorney agree to a 25-year sentence.
Did he adopt some kind of stance toward waging jihad against the United States? As he walked away from the courthouse, Malaku's father told me his son is a good person who respects his parents and authority. When we asked if his son has anger management issues, the father said he wasn't sure that they'd have to wait for an evaluation. Well,